Hello, my name is Ryden Fredericks, and I'll be playing Donkey from Shrek the Musical. I will be singing a song called Don't Let Me Go by Lindsay Aubert.
Hey, 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 you gotta let me go with you. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Well, maybe you do, but that's why we gotta stick together. No, 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 don't speak, don't speak, don't speak. Just hear me out. I might surprise you. I'll be your friend when others despise you. Don't roll your eyes. Stop with the moping. You need a pal. My calendar's open. I'll bring you soup when you feel congested. I'll bail you out when you get arrested. I got your back, whoa, whoa, whack. When things get scary, and I'll shave it. When things get hairy, don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. You need me. I'll treat you right and never act shoddy. If you kill a man, I'll hide the body. What do you say? You're not responding. I think we're bonding. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. You and me, we belong together. Like butter and grits. Like kibbles and bits. Like yin and yang, stern and drang. Like hang and jang, attached at the hips. But not an old lady hip that might break. I'm gonna be on you like a fat kid on cake. Like Cupid's psyche, like Pop Rocks and Mikey. We'll stick to the, like that Velcro stuff. I'm the fuzzy side, you'll be the spiky. Ooh, like little kids in pajamas with those funny things at the bottom. You know, feeties, like donuts and, oh, it goes with donuts. Donuts and diabetes. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Hold me. Hug me, take me, please. Na 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 na, please don't let me go. I need you, 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 I need you. Don't let me go, go, go. Don't let me go.
Hi, I'm Autumn Martin. I will be playing Eliza singing Burn from Hamilton by Lin-Manuel Miranda. I saved every letter you wrote me. From the moment I read them, I knew you were mine. You said you were mine. I thought you were mine. Do you know what Angelica said when we saw your first letter arrive? She said, be careful with that one love. He will do what it takes to survive. Even your words flooded my senses. Your sentences left me defenseless. You built me palaces out of paragraphs. You built cathedrals. I'm rereading the letters you wrote me. I'm searching and scanning for answers in every line, for some kind of sign that when you were mine, the world seemed to into our bed. In clearing your name, you have ruined our lives. Do you know what Angelica said when she read what you'd done? She said, you have married an Icarus. He's flown. too close to the sun. You and your words obsessed with your legacy. Your sentences border on senseless, and you are paranoid in every paragraph how they perceive you. I'm erasing myself from the narrative. Let future historians wonder how Eliza reacted when you broke her heart. You have torn it all apart. I'm watching it burn. Watching it burn. The world has no right to my heart. The world has no place in our bed. They don't get to know what I said. I'm burning the memories, burning the letters that might have redeemed you.
My name is Lucia Graves. I'll be singing Everything I Know from In the Heights by Lin-Manuel Miranda, and I am representing Thespian Troupe 4492.
Every little scrap of paper and our thoughts.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Cathy DeVoe, and I am representing troupe 4492, and today I'll be performing I'm Your Man from the musical Meet John Doe, with music and lyrics written by Andrew Jarrell. Thank you. Alright, just what you say, any way that you want. And when it comes to arguing, I'm a savant. I need money, you need me to make a stir. Rent my fingers, I'll throw in a Pulitzer. You need someone with talent and passion and brains. You need someone with newspaper ink in their veins. My coffee cup has lipstick stains, but brother, I'm your man. Anything you need done, I'm the one for the job. You want corny, I'll type it right off of the cob. Use my column, any topic, take your pick. I can slalom back and forth on rhetoric. You need someone who crosses her legs and her T's. I'm so quick that I've got my own personal breeze. I've got high heels and two of these, but brother, I'm your man. One day you will regret this. Dick, you could have had me for cheap. You'll say, Anne, please forget this. But I'll say, find a bridge and take a flying leap. Huh. You want fireworks? I'll give you the 4th of July. Lots of luck finding somebody better than I. Who could do it? Maybe Dorothy Parker's free. She few blew it. She ain't got a thing on me. Front page headline reads Mitchell land on her feet. Come to borrow some editors in for a treat. Just say the word.
My name is Chloe Dunn. I represent Troupe 4492, and I'll be singing Dying Ain't So Bad from Bonnie and Clyde the Musical, written by Frank Wildhorn and Don Black. Thank you. Dying ain't so bad, not if you both go together. Only when one's left behind dies it gets sad. But a short and loving life, that ain't so bad. I only hope to God that I go first. I couldn't live on memories. I'm sorry, but I'm not that strong. There are some things in life you can't replace. A love like ours don't happen twice when all his days are through. Mine will be. Cause dying ain't so bad, not if you both go together. Only when one's left behind does it get sad. but a short and loving life. That ain't so bad. I've met boys who talk about farms and horses, and they don't do much for me. I don't need to end up in a rocking chair. Seems you get to live your life just once, if that's how it's gotta be. Then I'd rather breathe in life than dusty air. Dying ain't so bad. Not if you both go together. Only when you're left alone does it get sad. But a short and loving life. A short and loving life. A short and loving life. That ain't so bad.
Hello, I'm Maia Travis, and I am from Troop 4492, and I will be playing the character Mary from Vanities the Musical, singing the song Fly Into the Future, written by Lauren Kennedy. There she goes again, look at Chatty Cathy, keeping track of life with her paper and pen. Then there's poor Joanne, desperate to marry, bringing up her wedding again and again. This would be my world, this is what I'm in for. Years of planning parties and P&O wife. Sing song, lying green. I don't want to be mean, but this isn't my scene. I feel like I need something bigger from life. Growing up was stifling, cause I was never free. School is getting stale, and I'm sick of this sorority. Think I need some distance, a place to disappear. So it's adios and away I go, and I'm kinda scared, but the moment's here to fly into the future. Gonna roll, gonna ride, so that no one can find me. I'm flying into the future. Moving on with my life and leaving all this behind me. Free from textbooks, free from Texas, free from folks who give me flack. I'm gonna fly into the future once I fly, and I'll never look back. I could grab my pencil and make some little plan. I could be a housewife and settle down to serve man. I could take a job with my bachelor's degree, but I think I'll go to the Coliseum and take some bachelors home with me and fly into the future, where there's no one to boss me or judge how I'm living. There's only me and my future, plus a couple Italian boys who lack what I'm given. No condemnments, no conditions, no connections that can last. Not when I fly into the future. Once I fly, I'll be through with my past. Mama is a coward. Mama is a drunk. Mama sleeps with Howard when she gets in a funk. Howard's kind of creepy. Howard's kind of crude. Howard's really fat and walks around in the nude. Dad ran off with Julie. Mama hates his guts. He's okay, but truly my whole family is nuts. Mama doesn't like me. I don't even try, which is why I just gotta say goodbye and fly into the future, where I'm up in the sky soon as Brandolph can take me. Into the future, gonna make me or break me. No restrictions, no relations, no ridiculous demands. Watch Mary fly into the future. Watch her fly. See her fly. And we'll see where she lands. And we'll see where she lands. And we'll see where she lands. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Andy Samashima, and I'll be performing If I Could Tell Her from Dear Evan Hansen by Benj Pasek and Justin Paul, and I'll be playing the character of Evan. He thought you were awesome. Definitely. Well, he said, there's nothing like your smile, sort of subtle and perfect and real. T said, you never knew how wonderful that smile could make someone feel. T knew, whenever you get bored, you scribble stars on the cuffs of your jeans. And he noticed that you still fill out the quizzes that they put in those teen magazines. But he kept it all inside his head. What he saw, he left unsaid. Though he wanted to, he could never talk to you. You couldn't find a way. But he would always say, if I could tell her everything I see, if I could tell her how she's everything to me, but we're a million worlds apart. I don't know how I would even start if I could tell her. If I could tell her. About you? No. He just said so many great things about you. I was just trying to figure out the best ones. He thought you looked really pretty. It was pretty cool when you put indigo streaks in your hair. Yeah. And he wondered how you learned to dance like all the rest of the world isn't there. But he kept it all inside his head. What he saw, he left unsaid. If I could tell her everything I see. If I could tell her how she's everything to me. But we're a million worlds apart. I don't know how I would even start if I could tell her. If I could tell her. But what do you do when there's this great divide? She just seems so far away. What do you do when the distance is too wide? It's like, I don't know anything. How do you say, I love you? I love you. I love you.
Hi, I am Bianca Meske. I'll be representing Troop 449, who will now be singing part of your role from The Little Mermaid, music and lyrics by Mankin and Ashman. Thank you. I just don't understand how a world that makes such wonderful things could be so bad. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around here, you think, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's it's and what's it's galore. You want bing bops? I've got Tony. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I want to be where the people are. I want to see, them dancing, walking around on those. What do you call them? Oh, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling along down the... What's that word again? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun. Wondering, wish I could be. If I could live out of these waters, what would I pay to spend a day warm on the sand? Betcha on land, they understand, but they don't reprimand their daughters. Bright young women, sick of swimming, ready to stand. What the people know. Ask them my questions and get some answers. What's a fire and what's it? What's the word? Bird. When's it my turn? Wouldn't I love, to explore the shore up
I'm Chandler Hinckley, and I'll be performing You Gotta Die Sometime from Falsettos the Musical. Music and lyrics written by William Finn, and I am proudly representing Troop 4492. Thank you. Doctor started using phrases like, "You'll pass away." What could I say? I said, "Doctor, in plain English, tell me why was I chosen? Why me of all men?" "Doctor, here's the good part. At least death means I'll never be scared about dying again. Can I keep on living while we can and not play dumb? Death's gonna come. When it does, screw the nerves, I'll be eating hors d'oeuvres. It's the roll of the dice and no crime. You gotta die sometime. Death is not a friend, but I hope in the end he takes me in his arms and lets me hold his face. He holds me in his arms and whispers something funny. He lifts me in his arms and tells me to embrace his attack. Then the scene turns to black. Life sucks. People always hate a loser and they hate lame ducks. Screw me and shucks. That's it. That's the ball game. I don't smoke, don't do drugs, and then comes the bad news. I quit. That's the ball game. It's the chink in the armor, the shit in the karma, the blues. Can I keep my cool despite the urge to fall apart? How should I start? I would cry if I could, but it does no damn good to explain. I'm a man in my prime. You gotta die sometime. Death's a funny pal with a weird sort of talent. He puts his arm around my neck and walks me to the bed. He pins me up against the wall and kisses me like crazy. The many stupid things I thought about with dread, now delight. Then the scene turns to white. Give me the balls to orchestrate a graceful leave. That's my reprise, to go out without care. My head high in the air, it's the last little mountain I'll climb. I'll climb. You gotta die sometime. You gotta die sometime. You gotta die sometime. You gotta die sometime, 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 sometime. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Cade Heaton.
My name's Abby Kors.
And we are from Troop 4492. We are performing a duet scene from The Bright Blue Mailbox Suicide Note. Thank you. Excuse me, is this the crisis center?
Jake?
Beanie?
Mr. Erskott, why don't you go into the lounge? The group's waiting for you.
What are you doing here?
I work here.
You work at a crisis center?
Don't sound so surprised.
I'm not surprised, it's just that...
I'm too flaky to stop people from committing suicide.
I didn't say that.
You don't have to. Don't worry, I'm only the receptionist. I make coffee, I answer phones, I type, and on rare occasions I read tarot cards.
Really?
The clients want to know if everything's going to be all right. Yes, Dr. Matt? Not yet. I'll let you know as soon as she gets here.
Baby, why didn't you tell me when you work at a crisis center?
Because.
I mean... You sound so normal. Not that you don't sound normal. BB, for God's sake, you're the weirdest person I know. You talk to spirits in the wall. You change your hair color every second of the day. You're a vegetarian. What am I supposed to think?
Ken knows.
What?
Ken knows I work here.
Well, why didn't he say anything? Or I guess he wouldn't.
Don't worry, he was as surprised as you the first time you walked in here.
Well, why didn't you tell me how he was feeling?
He didn't want you to know.
Did you talk to him?
A bit.
Well, why did he come here? What did he say?
I can't tell you.
But I'm his friend.
It's not my place to.
I'm his friend, not you, Bibi. Why do you get to know?
Because I am not here for you. This room holds a lot of secrets, and it's part of my job to not spread them around. If you think there's something you have a right to know, well, that's between you and Ken. I won't tell his secrets. Not to you, not to anyone.
BB, I'm not a bad person. Nothing's just the way it used to be anymore, and everything's just slipping through my fingers. 2 summers ago... We were up at the cottage, and it was dark. We just watched the sun go down, and Ken was getting moody. You know how he gets, and I guess I just left him alone. It was the best way to deal. I thought it was the best way to deal with it. Now the blue, He just said, have you ever thought of killing yourself? And I think I made a joke. What, are you gonna hang yourself over the babe at the bait shop? And he just laughed and never mentioned it again. But if I knew he was serious, I would have...
Why did you come in here, Jake?
I don't know. I want someone professional.
Do you want me to...
No. I don't know why I came here. Thanks anyways.
Jake, he doesn't blame you. He blames himself. Don't forget that.
But why would he say anything? He was the greatest guy I...
You better go. Don't tell anyone you saw me here, okay?
Hi, my name is Katie Heaton, and I'm performing two monologues today. My first one, I'm performing Puck from Midsummer, and my second one, I'm performing Sam from The Flick. Thank you. My mistress with the monster is in love. While she was in her dull and sleeping bowers, a crew of Patch's rude mechanics were met to rehearse a play, intended for a great thesis, Nupital Day. And the shallowest thick skin of the Baron forsook his scene and entered in a break. And asked his null I fixed on his head. And he murder cried and help from Athens calls, but I led them on this distracted fear and left sweet Pyramus translated there. When in that moment, so it came to pass, Titania waked and straightway loved an ass. You know what I hate the most? It's one thing if I sell you food. It's one thing if you legitimately know I sell you food. And now it's just like scattered all over the floor. But to sneak food in and leave empty bags of sun chips on your chair, that I don't understand. But sometimes it's the opposite. Sometimes it's like, I take that scoopy thing and I scoop that popcorn for you. I give you the bag. You hand me the money. You say thank you. And now it's all over the floor. I have a funny story. Someone left a nasty New Balance shoe. I don't know how you walk out of a movie theater with one shoe on and one shoe off. But maybe it was a sign of gang warfare or something. But what am I supposed to do with it? Am I supposed to put in the lost and found? No! It smells disgusting. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Kaleigh Imbler, and I will be doing a makeup design from Alice in Wonderland, written by Henry Coop. I am represented by Troop 4492. So first I wanted to talk a little bit about this adaptation of Alice in Wonderland and my design ideas. So this adaptation of Alice in Wonderland is heavily inspired by the original books, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland and Alice Through the Looking Glass. And this version was based in the Victorian era. So I tried basing my makeup trends in the Victorian era. And makeup trends during the Victorian era included blush on the apples of the cheeks, a paler face, darker eyes, and a bright red lip. So Alice in Wonderland is a fantasy tale about a girl named Alice who falls down a rabbit hole into a world of nonsense. So I wanted my makeup designs to fit this idea of nonsense and fantasy. First, I have the Mad Hatter. The Mad Hatter is a neurotic, childlike, and hyperactive character. So to make sure that I get the point across that he is hyperactive and erotic, I made his under eyes darker and I gave him exaggerated bottom eyelashes with eyeliner. And to fit along with the fantasy and nonsense of Alice in Wonderland, I gave him purple and green eyeshadow follow along with a white eyeliner since it doesn't really match. And to fit along with the Victorian era, I decided to give him bright orange blush on the apples of his cheeks, and I chose orange blush to match along with the theme of nonsense. So next, I have the Caterpillar. The Caterpillar is a wise, direct, self-entitled, and mystical character. So to go along with the theme of nonsense, I decided to make the Caterpillar blue. And to not wash out his face, I gave him darker blue features on his cheeks. And since he is a more wise character, I gave him wrinkles. And since he is more of a direct manure character, I decided to give him darker eyes. Next, I have the Queen of Hearts. The Queen of Hearts is a self-centered, angry, and powerful character. So to show that she is really self-centered, in place of the blush and lipstick, I put hearts there in the places where they would put makeup in the Victorian era. And to show that she is more of an angry character and to match the era, I gave her darker eye makeup. So next I have the White Rabbit. The White Rabbit is a fancy and fearful character. For this makeup design, I really wanted to get the point across that he is, in fact, a rabbit. So I decided to give him eyeliner that goes into the corners of his eyes, a black upper lip, and a triangle on his nose. And to match with the era, I gave him rosy blush on the apples of his cheeks, and I gave him white whiskers since he is the White Rabbit. So last but not least, I have the Cheshire Cat. The Cheshire Cat is a playful, mischievous, and insane character. And to go along with the theme of nonsense, I decided to make him purple. And I really wanted to stick to the original design for this character, so I gave him that mischievous Cheshire Cat smile. And to not wash out his features, I gave him pink eyebrows and a pink nose. So here are some of my first drafts of my design. Here we have the Cheshire Cat, which it was good, but it just wasn't enough, and it wasn't as much as I wanted to be. So here I have the Queen of Hearts. The Queen of Hearts is pretty similar to my final design, but it wouldn't have been noticeable from the audience. So I decided to give her bigger hearts and outline them with eyeliner. So next I have the Caterpillar, and the Caterpillar, you couldn't see the wrinkles because I made them silver. And then over here, I made them a darker blue, so they would be more noticeable. But like the Cheshire Cat, it just wasn't enough and as much as I wanted it to be. All right, that's all. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Claire Allward. And I'm Lucia Graves. We will be singing The End of the Line from Theory of Relativity by Neil Bartram.
We are representing Thespian Troop 4492. I will be playing Jenny.
And I will be playing Sarah.
I'm Jenny.
I'm Sarah.
She's Sarah.
She's Jen.
Been best friends forever, well, since we were 10. Met at ballet class, and ever since then, we became inseparable.
The damage was irreparable.
Jen's like my sister,
and Sarah's like mine.
Friends till the end of the line. Had nothing much in common, loved horses,
loved shoes,
but we were attached at the hip. Jen was like a goddess, my mentor, my muse.
She was a nerd and a drip.
But we would be together every hour of the day. People would see us and say, it's Jenny and Sarah,
two peas in a pod.
Well, if one pea was perfect
and one pea was odd,
first string and spare on the volleyball squad.
Happy and gregarious, my girls were just vicarious.
Woo!
She'd point the spotlight,
she'd bask in the shine, friends till the end of the line.
My skin was just like porcelain, hers was all zits.
My pores were perpetually blocked.
I developed early,
she had no tits.
My cupboard was woefully stocked.
Why would I be seen with such a social refugee?
You always looked good next to me.
That's right.
So we were Jenny and Sarah, a vulgar display. Queen of the prom and her weird protege. I starred, I ran light in the school cabaret.
I mean, have you heard Sarah sing? Good golly, it's embarrassing.
We're contrary forces who somehow combined. Friends till the end of the line.
And something crazy happened right after 12th grade. That summer I blossomed and bloomed. I stepped into the sunlight after years in the shade. And a beautiful swan was exhumed.
Meanwhile, I was working at the local Dairy Queen and ballooned up to plus size 8. 16. Jenny. 18. It's just so delicious.
We both showed up at college and no need to pretend. I was popular right off the bat. And everyone was asking Sarah, who is your friend? The one who's so interesting. That... All this malice aimed at Jenny was quite startling and new. So I did what all best friends would do. I said, I'm Sarah, she's Jenny. We used to be close. Now she's desperate and clingy and sort of morose. I heard she gobbles peanut butter parfaits by the gross. In all worlds, there's a sight more tragic than this parasite.
So that is our story, and ain't it divine? Friends till the end of the
conference.
I guess this is the end of the line.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ryden Fredericks, and I will be playing Jeremy.
My name is Andy Samashima, and I'll be performing Michael.
And we will be performing two-player game
from the musical Be More Chill
by Ned Vizin
and Joe Tranks.
Apocalypse of the Dead!
Level 9!
The Cafetorium!
Find the bad guy, push him aside, then move on forward with your friend at your side. It's a two-player game, so when they make an attack, you know you got a brother gonna have your back. Then you stay on track and all remain on course, and if they give you a smack, you gotta use your force. And if you leave your brother behind, it's lame, it's a napped up world, it's a two-player game, hey!
Dude, you are cooler than a vintage cassette. It's just that no one else but me thinks that yet. You're just a nothing in this high school scheme, but it's okay, cause you and I are a team. We like out of print games, retro skates, got a Pac-Man tattoo. Nobody here appreciates, but soon we'll be together where they do. Cause guys like us are cool in college, we're cool in college, this I know. Guys like us are cool in college, we rule in college, yes I know. High school is hell, but we navigate it well, cause me and you, we make it a two-player game.
Stop it! Watch out!
As losers, we have fought together for years. Both Nintendo zombies and our popular peers. Now we're stuck on a level and I wanna move on.
Just wait 2 years here upon, you'll realize
guys like us are cool in college. Cool in college,
won't be lame.
Dude, I know, I get it, guys like us are cool in college. But we're not in college.
All the same. High school is whack, but we've got each other's back. Cause me and you, we make it a two-player game.
Ah!
Oh. Zombie! Blood! Claws!
Paws.
You know that you are my favorite person. That doesn't mean that I can't still dream. Is it really true I'm your favorite person? Yeah, we're never not gonna be a team. High school is crap, and you gotta help me conquer it. It's just what we do. We make it a two-player game. Find the bad guy, push him aside. Then move on forward with your friend at your side. It's a two-player game, so when they make an attack, you know you got a brother gonna have your back. Then you stay on track and all remain on course. And if they give you a smack, you gotta use your force. And if you leave your brother behind, it's late, because it's an effed up world and it's a two-player game. Hey! Two-player game! Two-player game! Hey!
Hello, my name is Cathy DeVoe.
And I'm Chandler Hinckley.
And we are proudly representing troop 4492.
We'll be performing Barbara 2.0 from Beetlejuice the Musical.
With music and lyrics written by Eddie Perfect. Thank you.
Thank you. You don't like this stuff? Barbara, this is our stuff. Well, then maybe we should just go. What? Barbara! Okay, that wasn't as much fun as I thought it would be. We're not kombucha people, we did find that out. What? I never even used this. Oh, but then I felt bad I never used it.
Break it.
Barbara, you're right. I think I've been hiding.
I don't know.
Stuck out of sight like my unused aluminum siding. Tragic and static, trapped in the static. Now Adam is shedding his skin. No more. We're no longer useless, we've got nothing to lose. We can finally begin. The new Adam is wiser, the old one's fertilizer. Time to let go, say hello. That must be the reason she sees us. Maven 2.0.
Thank you.
Thank you.